this series of five that four we have already talked about, and we talked about the new challenges, we talked about self-relationship, we talked about outer relationship, we also talked about the pregnancy and the importance of being partner in progress. Now we are going to talk the other aspect of upbringing, and upbringing, the communications and the reactions. So the parent and the child are extremely important. Today, wherever we see, I think the major problem is coming out from the communication. And as you very well know, the communication is nothing but an expression of the mind. We always communicate through our throat. And whenever the communication comes in the mind, if the mind is corrupt, the communication is awry. And a lot of people have not understood this. So I think what you need to do, if you really want to have the bad effects and the bad fallout of the particular situation, you have to understand that the bad fallout is basically coming from your reactions. And the reactions are basically coming from your mind. Now, so somewhere the mind needs to be looked at. Manage the manageable, manage the mind. And the moment you manage the mind, probably you'll realize that communication is improved. But when you're restless with yourself, when you're fighting within your own mind, when there's a tremendous fight and there's impurities between your chitta, the mind and intellect and the emotions, I think ultimately we lead to very bad situations. So somewhere we need to understand how to communicate, how to upbring. In the first 6 years, he just learns from the observation, and not many parents know about it. You cannot teach him, and we are all trying to teach him, maybe due to the modern education methods. You are actually trying to overload him, and I was reading some experts' books on that, and they say that actually the brain skips certain logical steps, and ultimately these children land up into some kind of dyslexia or that kind of mental disorders, because you know, the brain has already skipped and it cannot be reversed. So I mean, I was reading somewhere that if the child at the age of 2.5 or 3, you ask him to write and make him forcefully write ABCD and all, actually we don't have the writing faculty developed at that time. Because the ability comes from the brain. And that brain has already not gone through that step at all. Brain is much behind, and you are just trying to force the brain to do something which is not natural. In the process, it tries to adjust itself. And in the process, the brain becomes unnatural. And the child creates a lot of stress. And probably that explains a lot of hyperactivity, hyper nature of the children today. You know, many parents come to us and say, my child is 2.5 year old and he's extremely hyper. I can't understand, how can a 2.5 year old be hyper? How can he be violent? I mean, he has not even learned violence in life. He has not even seen violence in life. So somewhere that violence is coming because you're forcing it to be unnatural. You know, anything which is unnatural creates the stress. And that is something which is a very simple definition for people to understand. So try to be with the nature, flow with the nature, allow the nature to take over. You know, as I read somewhere beautiful, when it comes to healing, a doctor said, and he is a doctor none other than Dr. Hippocrates probably, the one who founded allopathy, and he says, the nature is the doctor, we are the assistant. Somewhere I think that feeling is getting lost in the medical science today. Somewhere I think the science is losing that thread. And I think we should bring it back for a better life, better communication, better upbringing. If you can communicate, communication is a simple resonance. If a lot of love within, you can activate the love around. If a lot of hatred within, you activate the hatred around. Because what you have, you resonate with. Okay? I mean, I know this, oxygen is not in the active form all around you. It's in the latent form. We make it active by our inner oxygen. Same thing happens to our love, compassion. So unless the parents have the love and compassion experiences themselves, today they feel that they are not happy. A husband and a wife both are unhappy with themselves. How can they produce a happy child? You know, when they are both rigid, how can they have a flexible child? Now, somewhere I think the time has come for us to understand that the parenting, as I understood from psychological book, and the author is very strong about it, he says parenting is not natural. Giving a birth is. But by giving a birth, you become a father or a child, not parent. That's why in wild animals, there are no parents. They are only probably fathers and mothers. No? But somewhere we need to understand, one has to make efforts to become a good parent. And in this chapter, we basically talk of the role of the upbringing and the communication and the interaction with the parent, child or husband, wife. So that plays a major role. So thank you very much and God bless you.